All right, let's start out by talking about Google Analytics accounts and the best practices that are surrounded by that. Now, Google Analytics accounts, just to show you the structure here, are really governed by one single login. So first of all, in order to actually access all of this, you need to log into your Google account. Once you have done that, you can access Google Analytics accounts. So there can be multiple accounts per login, and you are free to create up to 100 accounts per login. If somebody else gives you access to account, this won't count against the quota. So my recommendation there is to actually always ask your client to open up their own Google Analytics account and give you full administrative access to it. That's also very important because if anything happens to your Google account, maybe it gets banned because you have done bad stuff on Google Plus or on YouTube, you don't want to affect that to your client's Google Analytics account. So my recommendation here, ask your client to open up the account and give you access to it. Now, once you are in an account, the structure is as follows. You have accounts which serve as a central management for Google Analytics. Within those accounts, you have properties, and those really are the different tracking codes that you may have installed. And within a property, then you have views, which are really just the perspective of data. And within views, you can apply certain configurations and filters. Now, as a best practice on how to set this up, I would say that name your account according to the company. Let's say the company would be Google. As the different properties, you put in the websites. So for example, YouTube, Google Search, Google Plus, and so on and so on. So different tracking codes for different properties. And then in the view filter will be something we'll talk about after we set up the Google Analytics tracking codes. And one thing to remember, on all these accounts level, you can give access rights out. So if you want to give access to the webmaster who should have control over everything, you can give him account access and he can put in new properties or views. If you want to give access to a specific webmaster who is only responsible for one site, you would do that on a property level. And if you just want to give access to the data, you would give that on a view level. So there are different levels of access, and I would encourage you to map that out, who in the organization should get access, or ask the client about it. Easiest one, of course, would be administrative access to the account, but this would also mean that the user could potentially delete something or alter the data within those accounts. So map that out and find out who you should give access on which level. Now let's take a look on how to set up things in Google Analytics. Now here we are in our Google Analytics account. You can find it under google.com/analytics. Obviously you have to sign in with your Google account. If you don't have a Google account, you need to create one first. And once you're in here, you'll see an account overview. So these are all the accounts that are within the reach of my Google login. And once you click into them, you'll find the property and the profiles that are set up. Now, in order to set up a new account, we actually need to click into one first and click on admin in order to get the right panel. And then we'll see a pretty nice overview here of the account property and view structure. Now, in order to open up a new account, we'll go onto the account tab here and create a new account. And the first step is to choose if we want to track a website or a mobile app. Now, this course will only cover the website. The mobile app functions a little bit different. It's also a different installation process. So if you want to go through that, there will be different configurations that you might need to make. Now, the first step here is to choose an account name. And I would encourage you to choose here the organization's name. So for example, company.inc. And then you're already in the property settings, because you can't set up an account without having a property set up. So we'll have here the website name and the website URL. Now these match right now, which is not unusual. We can leave that at as it is. And now we can choose the industry category. And this is not really required, so you don't have to do this. What it will help you later on is to gather benchmarking data. And with these categories, you'll be able to benchmark your sites against other sites in the category and maybe see and identify trends. Now, if you don't want to do this, there's actually, you don't have to choose a category, and down here you can opt out of the data sharing and the benchmarking with other sites. But let us first get to the reporting time zone. Now this is a very important option. Please make sure the reporting time zone is set to the time zone of the actual website. So if you have an online store and it operates in New York, you should set the right time zone in those fields, because otherwise the reports don't match up with the back end of the shop, and this can lead to problems if you want to compare the data and you need to always go back and forth of transferring the time zones. So be very sure to choose the right time zone here. And then you get to the data sharing options, and here you can opt in to share the data with other Google products, to share your data with the benchmarking reports within Google Analytics. You can get technical support and accounts support if you are, for example, hooked up to AdWords and they want to take a look into your Google Analytics account. They'll be able to do this easily if those options are pre-ticked. But obviously you don't have to do that. If your client doesn't want to share any data, you can opt out of all these options. I usually leave them on because I get very, very good data with the benchmarking reports later. And once all of this is done, we can get our tracking ID. Now there will be a little bit of TSC that you need to read and accept or don't. And once that is done, we are basically already in the property section where we'll get our web tracking code. Now let's go back to the account and start setting up our tracking.